When you think of a solar array, solar panels get all the attention, but there's one critical component that attaches the solar panel to the roof. Today, we're at the S-5 manufacturing facility in Iowa Park, Texas, where we're gonna take an exclusive inside look at how S-5 manufactures that one critical component that attaches your solar panels to the roof. Come, let's take a look. So I'm here with Harry Carner. Harry is the VP of manufacturing here at S-5. And Harry, you've been here since the beginning of the manufacturing process here at S-5.
I've been involved with Rob Haddock in manufacturing parts since 1992.
Wow. So tell us a little more about S-5. How long have you been in business? What industries do you serve? What all do you do here?
S-5 has been in business since 1992. The manufacturing portion of S-5 was started in 2011. We took possession of our first equipment in January of 2012 and then shipped our first parts beginning April of the same year. Industries we serve, we're exclusively metal roof. We're the metal roofing experts. So we manufacture attachment devices for standing seam and through fastened metal roofing to attach snow retention systems, solar, and miscellaneous other things, which we call utility.
So tell us more about the facility here in Iowa Park, Texas. How many people do you employ? How large is it? Those types of things.
The building itself was 72,000 square feet under roof. And currently we have approximately 100 people employed and we're a 24/7 operation.
And am I understanding that everything that S-5 manufactures comes from this facility?
That is exactly right. Last year we produced approximately 1 million parts a month.
Wow, cool. All right, so before we get out on the floor today, Harry, we have a pretty good cross-section of a lot of the products you make here at S-5. Can you kind of explain what we're seeing here?
Sure. On this lower shelf, the first shelf here, is our snow retention products. The color guard in the corner being our flagship snow retention product. Second shelf is clamps. Clamps are used for standing seam metal roofing. Third shelf are brackets that are used on through fastened or face attached metal roofing.
And then these four items up here are the ones that we're going to see on the floor today. Can you just explain a little bit more about those
four?
You bet.
First one is the core bracket. It's obviously used on corrugated roofing. Second product is, again, one of our flagship products. That is our S5U, this one being a mini. And primary use for it is solar attachment. This product you'll see quite a bit of out there today. This is our Protea bracket. It's used on various width trapezoidal profiles. So it's a very universal product for mounting solar. And then the solar foot, which is used in the low on face attached roofing for mounting solar.
Great. Let's go out on the floor and take a look.
You bet.
So now we're here in the S-5 facility, and I'm here with Jeff Myers, the plant manager here at S-5. Jeff, there's a lot of product in this room right here. Tell us what's going on.
Yes, this is our extrusion warehouse. We have high vertical ceiling, so we store everything vertically. So we can store over 4 million pounds worth of extrusion in our extrusion warehouse.
So basically, the raw materials come into here, and then you guys take them, you cut them, you do everything else with the product out there.
Right, everything comes in 16-foot lengths. We have four directional forklift that can get in these narrow aisles, take that 16-foot extrusion, deliver it to the saw, but we're gonna cut it down to 1 to 2 inch lengths.
Okay, so we have the parts cut to length, and I'm seeing seven machines down the row here. What's happening here?
So we're drilling and tapping the set screws and the mounting holes on each one of these parts. And so we're drilling and tapping in two planes. And so the operators processing those parts.
And the goal here is to keep these machines running as much as absolutely possible. How do you do that?
The machine is drilling and tapping while the operator is putting fresh parts in the fixtures to be processed at the same time that the machine is drilling and tapping.
Okay, and so here we have a before and after. This is before, and then we have an after, and the after has a hole on each side.
That's correct.
Ready to go. So we have a robotic welder behind us here, Jeff. What is it doing?
So it's taking two parts of our tortilla assembly, and you align them in the fixture, and it's welding both sides to make it a structural weld between the two pieces.
And again, the goal is to keep the welder running as often, as quickly as possible, as much as possible.
That's correct. So while the operator's loading this side, the welder, the robotic welder, is welding the parts together on the other side. And when the operator's done, he hits two safety buttons to let the robot know that that he's ready. And as soon as it's finished welding, the table will turn around and automatically start welding fresh parts. And the operator starts the process all over.
So how many pieces do we have that are being welded at once here?
So there's 20 parts on each fixture. There's 20 parts on this side and 20 parts on the other side.
So in my opinion, Jeff, this is the coolest machine that you guys have. So these components are now welded together. So what happens next?
Yeah, so it takes two of these welded components, along with the mounting L bracket, a carriage bolt and a nut, and assembles it into the final product.
Wow, so as long as I keep the products going into the machine, it'll keep spitting them out here at the end with no intervention from me.
That's correct. So those bolt feeders put all the components in the correct position and feed the automation cell.
So Jeff, here we have an assembled PV kit on a clamp. Help us understand what part of the process is happening here.
Yeah, so once the part is cut to the correct length at the saw, then it's brought over here to have this hole punched along with the S-5 logo and the part name.
Great, let's go see the next step. So what's happening here at this machine?
Yeah, so they're taking this 4-foot stainless steel bar and machining the standoff.
And so that's this piece right in here.
Correct.
All right, so how do they do that? They cut it to length, what all do they do there?
So this is machined down to size and then threaded. And then there's some live tooling that comes in and machines these two flat for a wrench. And then it's transferred over and then cut off and then a hole drilled and then tapped.
And if you have this machine loaded, it can run by itself for a little while.
Oh yeah, if it's fully loaded, then 6 to 8 hours by itself with no operator intervention.
So now this is the assembly step. So what's happening here?
Yeah, so they're marrying up the standoff, the punch part, along with the bolt, to have a finished product that's ready for packaging.
So now this is the packaging step where we take the final product and put it in the box. Explain what all is happening here.
So they're doing the final inspection, making sure every part doesn't have any defect, and then arranging them, making sure the correct quantity's in here, adding the PV disc along with the tool that's required for installation.
So they're making sure the proper quantity's there, they're double checking for quality. Now they've been doing a quality check throughout every step of the process, but now at this final step, they're doing one final double check to make sure everything looks right before it goes in the box so it's ready for us.
That's correct. So we have one last person that gets to see the product, and they're the last person that sees it before the customer sees it. So we'll make sure that everything's correct, and that's where this is done.
Great. Thanks. So this brings us to the last step in our process, Jeff. We have boxes of finished product here behind us. What are we seeing here?
Yeah, this is our finished goods warehouse. We're product ready to be assembled per the customer's order and ship out the door.
Great. Well, thanks for your time today, Jeff. While S5 has been 100% U.S. manufactured right from the start, more and more solar components are being made today, right here in the U.S., than ever before. Here at the Solar Energy Channel, our goal is to highlight U.S. manufacturing of solar components. If you're interested in more facility tours just like this one, check out our playlist.